Very much for the invitation, and truly a delight being here with you in India, along with my colleagues from Montefiore and Einstein. Let me begin by saying that I had no specific understanding of how many of you are coming from established lung transplant programs, even though they might be small, and how many of you have the desire and the wish to establish a lung transplant program. So beginning with that, I thought I would share with you how these things, first of all, get started in our minds and how we go from concept to implementation from the institutional perspective. How does the Apollo Hospitals, Montefiore Medical Center, the Cleveland Clinic, any specific site around the world begin in the process of establishing a lung transplant program? Usually this is an idea, it's a dream, or it may even be a directive. This could be vague at first, with limited understanding of all of the issues, apart from the fact that there's an underlying desire to establish a lung transplant program. It could, in fact, be a request from a very high-level individual within the institution, such as the CEO of the hospital, the dean of the hospital, a chairman of a department. What's critical is that the person who is initiating this conversation have a deep understanding of the institutional issues and processes required in order to create and establish a program of this magnitude, because this is indeed a tour de force. And in my personal opinion, this should not ever be considered independent of already having an established heart transplant program. The two go together, and I think it is insufficient and incorrect to think that just because you might do kidney transplants or liver transplants, that now you can go and do lung transplants without having experience with heart transplantation. Lung and heart transplantation are more similar, but there are also dissimilarities, such as dissimilarities with the management of immunosuppression. And you certainly can't have someone, in my opinion, who manages kidney transplant immunosuppressive therapy think they can manage lung transplants. It takes patience, it takes time, and there's always politics involved. But the underpinning of all of this is that it requires some research on your part. Consumer research, understanding whether the physician team is supportive, whether your referring physicians are interested and supportive, because you need to bring in a pipeline of patients. You need to understand your competition. In the United States, I think this is more of an issue than it is in India, because India, like Europe, like Russia and other countries, have regional centers. So this may not be as significant here in India. And I do think it's advisable to get consultants. Consultant experts from other programs that are established programs that understand the clinical issues, but it's also important to get financial experts who can help you develop the business plans, understand the expense, because we all understand the benefit. We want to do something to help our patients, but unless we understand the difficulties, the road, the hills, the mountains we have to climb in order to establish this at our centers, we won't be able to, in the end, provide the greatest benefit to our patients. This is a chess game. This is an understandable process. This is something that you can do, but it requires tremendous attention, thought, and your every move must, in fact, be a concept to implementation process where you're thinking about where you want to go and how you want to move the pieces on the chessboard. So, one of the things that I've found in my personal experience to be very helpful in all of this is to create coalitions, create partnerships, develop good relationships and supportive alliances with your colleagues in the hospital, with your hospital administration, with your referring doctors. And I might mean this in a deeper sense, not the particularly easy one to think about, which is a friendly coffee. This needs to be a deep emotional conversation about where you're going, what you want to do, how you need help in order to accomplish this, and identify those factors that you specifically need someone else's help to allow the program to mature and develop. Remember, there are persons, each of us as leaders have persons that are under our supposed control because they report to us. Most of those people are people that are going to be supportive of your plans. But the most important and difficult challenge is to get people who are outside of your control, outside of your leadership plan, to be able to support you and help you with your desire to create this lung transplant program. And they also become part of your team and can help you with the challenging persons or situations of which we understand the politics of the field of healthcare. No country is without the politics of healthcare, and whenever you find yourself in a situation of new development, such as a lung transplant program, these issues will come up. Hospital administration must be on your side, university officials, government officials, very importantly, because in different regions of the world, the government has a say in what you're allowed to do, and especially who will pay you for what service you anticipate providing. And also consider the importance of people who have the means to support your efforts, whether that's in the purchase of a new technology, creation of a new infrastructure, a building, a location to care for your patients.